Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Getting Started with the FSW External Generator Control. In this presentation, we'll explain how to configure and use the External Generator Control option on Rohde Schwarz FSW series signal and spectrum analyzers. The External Generator Control option, FSW-B10, allows external RF signal generators to be used by the FSW as so-called tracking generators. This enables scalar network analysis of two-port devices, such as filters, as well as for one-port devices, such as antennas. These are more commonly referred to as transmission and reflection measurements. For both measurement types, the FSW controls the output power and frequency of the signal generator over either a LAN or GPIB connection. External generator control is accessed by pressing the input-output hard key on the front of the FSW and then selecting External Generator Config. There are three configuration tabs under External Generator Control. Measurement configuration is used to define the generator output power and frequency. The Interface Configuration tab is where the connection method and generator parameters are configured. And Source Calibration is used both to remove the effects of cables and connectors, as well as to enable normalization of the measurement results. We'll start with interface configuration. Here we select the type or model of generator from a list of predefined types. We also need to choose the interface used to connect the FSW to the generator. This can be either GPIB or TCP/IP, that is, an Ethernet or LAN connection. The GPIB address or the IP address slash hostname must also be entered. TTL handshake is a topic that we'll come back to in a few minutes. The type of frequency reference can also be configured. Internal uses the FSW's own internal frequency reference, but for best accuracy, the FSW and the generator should share the same frequency reference. Note that source capabilities of the selected generator are shown but are grayed out. This is because these parameters are not directly editable, but rather are read from a generator setup file. Supported signal generators must have a generator setup file. This is a plain text file that can be viewed or edited by pressing Edit Generator Setup File. Generator setup files define both the frequency and power ranges supported by the generator, as well as communication parameters. The FSW comes preloaded with setup files for many common analog and vector signal generators, but setup files can also be created and/or modified to support other instruments. Next, we'll look at the Measurement Configuration tab. Source state toggles the generator on or off, and source power defines the generator output power. An offset can be configured to account for any gain or attenuation in the signal path from the generator to the device under test. The result pane at the bottom of the screen shows the start and stop frequencies of the sweep. These are also not directly user editable, but rather are derived from the FSW settings and the frequency coupling parameters. In the default auto mode, the external generator sweeps over the same range as the range configured on the FSW. That is, the generator has the same start and stop frequencies as those configured on the FSW. This generator sweep range can, however, be modified in two ways. It can be multiplied by a user-specified factor, and/or it can be shifted by a user-specified offset. There's also a manual mode, which simply sets the generator output to a single fixed frequency. Now let's come back to the topic of TTL handshaking. When the FSW and generator are connected over GPIB, the default behavior is that the FSW sends each frequency point to the generator individually. Some Rohde and Schwarz signal generators support something called TTL synchronization. When this is enabled, the FSW sends the entire frequency list to the generator before beginning the sweep. When source state is enabled, a TTL signal from the FSW's aux control connector sends a trigger signal to the generator. This signal indicates when the generator should step to the next frequency point in the list. TTL handshaking therefore allows much faster measurements when using GPIB as the connection method. Next, we'll discuss calibration, which is the process by which the effects of cables, connectors, etc. are removed from the measurement results. Calibration involves replacing the dot with a through, in the case of transmission measurements, or with an open and or short, in the case of reflection measurements. The result of a calibration is a reference trace, which shows absolute measured power values in units of dBm. For network measurements, this trace is usually normalized to a 0 dB straight line. Measurements made of the device under test are shown in units of dB relative to this normalized reference trace. Calibration is configured and run from the Source Calibration tab. There are three calibration types: transmission, reflection short, and reflection open. Note that if both a short and an open calibration are performed, the reference trace is calculated from their average. Normalization can be enabled or disabled, assuming that calibration has already been performed. The recall button does not recall saved calibration data, but rather restores the measurement settings that were used when calibration was last run. This can be useful if instrument settings were changed after calibration. Next, we'll look at an example of a transmission measurement using a bandpass filter as a DUT. The generator output is connected to the input connector of the DUT, and the output of the DUT is connected to the RF input of the FSW. Once the connection is established, the FSW will display power versus frequency for the filter. Note that when this test setup is calibrated, the DUT is replaced by a through connector. On the FSW, we can see the results of a bandpass filter measurement. The trace shows normalized power in dB versus frequency. Recall that with normalization on, the displayed values are all relative to a normalized value of 0 dB. Enabling markers allows us to easily determine numerous filter parameters, such as the center frequency of the passband, the insertion loss within the passband, the level of attenuation or rejection outside of the passband, and the 3 dB bandwidth of the filter. Note that Q, the quality factor of the filter, is also automatically calculated and displayed by the FSW. Next, we'll look at a sample reflection measurement. The generator output is connected to the input connector of a visoir bridge, or suitable directional coupler. The FSW is connected to the output connector of the visoir bridge, and the DUT, here an antenna, is connected to the DUT port of the visoir bridge. When measurements are made, these will show the level of reflected power or return loss. Note that during calibration, the DUT would be replaced by a short and or an open calibration standard. Here is an example reflection measurement result. Remember that the trace shows return loss in dB. Greater values of return loss indicate lower levels of reflected power, and thus better impedance matching between source and load. Here again, we can use markers to obtain more detailed numerical results. The point of maximum return loss occurs at approximately 130 MHz, and this is sometimes called the resonant frequency of the antenna. The points at which return loss is minus 10 dB correspond to the points at which visoir or voltage standing wave ratio is 2. These values are often used to define the bandwidth of an antenna, and in this example, the distance between these two points is slightly greater than 5 MHz. Let's end with a brief summary. The FSW B10 option enables the FSW to control external RF signal generators for the purpose of making scalar network measurements. Both transmission or two-port and reflection or one-port measurements can be made in this way. Note that reflection measurements do, however, require an external visoir bridge or directional coupler. The FSW controls the generator over either a LAN or GPIB connection. The generator's sweep frequency range is normally coupled directly to the FSW span. That is, the generator sweeps the same frequency range as that configured on the FSW. But this range can be modified by a scale factor and/or an offset. And finally, the FSW supports both calibration and normalization of the measurement trace results. This concludes our presentation, Getting Started with the FSW External Generator Control. If you'd like to learn more about network measurements or about spectrum analyzers and signal generators from Rohde and Schwarz, please see the links in the video description. Thanks for watching.